Greetings! Welcome to Tuesday's live stream.
It's Tuesday. It's 4 o'clock. That means it's
time a live stream.
Yeah.
We see Creeps is already here. Hello. Don't upload your video 5 minutes before the stream starts. Fuck you. I just don't want to have to wait until six to put it live. I've got things to do tonight.
You could have scheduled it, I mean.
Nope.
Well.
Because I just wanted to get it live so people can see it.
I see.
Hi Potato, hi Mystery Soup, hi Azriel Frisk, hi Jane, hi Yana's back, welcome!
Woo!
Dryce has joined the party, a new challenger approaches.
Yay!
How you all doing, everyone?
CSGO's here!
Ah, oh, Alex, hello. You're finally back!
Haven't seen you in ages. Seeing as Alex is here, that seems a good time to bring up. We've just booked our slot at MCM VidFest, we've booked our table.
Indeed we have.
All we have to do now is pay for the table, which is very expensive, but it's all worth it to see you guys.
OMG, CSGO is back.
OMG indeed. Ah, work, busy. How are we doing today, guys? It's Tuesday, it's spring now, isn't it?
It is.
The hour's gone forward, how about that, eh? It's quite warm in London. It's nice.
I'm doing good, how are you guys, Harry and Ed? All right?
Yeah.
I'm happy to be back here, guys. Let's have a great time. Hi, Miss Lulu, Faye. How are you doing? Welcome.
Thanks for buying our shirts as well. That's much appreciated.
Indeed.
We're very keen to see what they look like on an Australian, and they're being sent to Australia, which is a new for us.
Sorry, it's been really busy with ATC. That's your flight training, isn't it? How's that all going?
Sounds like fun.
Gimingo, Lord of Something, Flashing Blue Neon. It's been so long. Welcome back.
Birthdays, pregnancies, zombie apocalypse. Well, funny you say pregnancies. No.
Well, I can't stay all stream because my friends and I go to the cinema. Goodness, what are you going to see? Do you know the number and when can I order tickets? I don't know.
So if you go onto the MCM website, you can buy tickets now.
Already, okay.
Yeah, you can buy them already. It's just MCM, search that on Google, you'll find it. And then, yeah, you buy tickets for the whole weekend, just one day. And in fact, I think the early bird tickets might have already sold out because people aren't very keen to get that.
Oh shit, Mystery Soup, you're right. We didn't tell Yana about Guam. Fuck.
Oh, yeah.
Yana, just don't Google Guam. It's a real fucking bloodbath. It's been good, a lot of marching recently. I hate that. You don't join the CCF and RAF stuff to do the marches, you join it to go flying. They make you do all the bullshit.
You know, I can understand, like, soldiers, you know, marching, because that's what soldiers do, but RAF? We fly planes.
Yeah.
We don't need to march.
I'm missing the last few minutes of the stream. I'm meeting an author.
Oh, right. Goodness. Should be good fun.
Hi, KS, how's it going?
Do you stream on a Saturday? Because it's 11 a.m. here.
I mean, once I move, we're going to start streaming most nights anyway, so probably. Just keep an eye out. That's going to be from April.
Tits McGee's here. Hi, bitches.
Sup, Tits McGee. My chicken nuggets are in the oven now. Great.
Hashtag Chicken Nugget Tuesday. Sounds good to me.
Chicken Nugget Tuesday? Those don't work.
They could work.
I'm hot and sweaty.
Nice. Yeah, I mean, what else has been going on the past few months?
Marching is all part of the discipline. Yeah, fair enough.
True.
It does teach you discipline. It is tiring in my spare time. I'm an army cadet. It's fun, but tiring. Yes.
Move the office? No, just, we have a feeling there might be some changes coming in the coming weeks. We don't know what those will be just yet. Circumstances are changing. We'll leave you guys into more of that when we know more ourselves.
Indeed. Whose bright idea was it to upload today's video just before the stream? Mine! I said that to you at the start of the stream, obviously you weren't here. But yeah, I couldn't be fucked to wait, so I just put it online. So what's on today's schedule? There's never a schedule. So, anything. 90 days as PewDiePie, goodness.
Yeah. Do you watch Doctor Who? Yes, I used to Flashing Blue Neon. I think the last season really went downhill. I feel like Moffat's writing has been so bad. They've wasted Capaldi. They really have. And I feel like a fresh start with a new Doctor and Chris Chibnall could be a good thing. And Doctor Who might come back to form.
Have you heard of Rooster Teeth? Everyone's heard of Rooster Teeth, aren't they? They're like part of the founding people who do YouTube.
Yeah. Streaming on a few minutes, Ed's already sweaty, is he?
I was wiping undershirt.
Alright, goodness me.
Hi Alex, how's it going?
How are we all doing, guys? Having a good day?
Now it's 5 minutes past four. Where is Spammels? Did you bitches see the Justice League trailer? Yeah, looks alright.
Yeah.
You know, You know exactly what it was going to be when you saw the trailer.
It's true. I mean, there wasn't much different from that and the sneak peek there at least a while ago.
Have you guys seen
the Spider-Man trailer?
Roses are red, I like spaghetti, I will kill you in the Serengeti. It's an awfully specific one, Mystery Soup.
Nice.
I don't want to play Stardew Valley. Can we play that game, oh shit, what's the name of it? We played it last week, Tuesday stream, at the end, it was fun.
Quiplash? Which one was that? Tell you what, I'm saying, to find out what game that was by reviewing last week's stream, and we could go into it then.
Yes, that is a horrible, horrible, horrible backing tune, creeps. Oh dear, how long has this been on? There, now that's way more gangster and grime.
Yeah.
By the way, I've been watching all the videos, but not the streams. I've tried to show as much support as possible, but I apologise for my absence. Sorry, mate, you're busy. You're busy saving our country, protecting our people.
Yeah, and thank you for the support. Still, you know, even you're not here, you're supporting us, which we very much appreciate.
No, you're out of tune.
I went to a chiptune gig the other day, and two of the artists, like, there was a guy playing some really good songs, and there was a girl singing, and she was so out of tune. And I was chatting to people at the bar, I was like, they're out of tune. She's like, no, that's on purpose. That's like, she's meant to be out of tune, that's their style. And I was like,
fuck off.
What possible style could want to be out of tune?
Just like, fuck off.
It's atrocious.
There's never an excuse for that.
Yeah.
People say the same about Tom York of Radiohead. I have regular arguments with Tall Joe about this. There has been a new game mode update on Rocket League, if you maybe want to try it. Yeah, I could try that.
Sounds good, yeah.
Do we have it installed?
I'm sure we could install it quickly. I already had some bad recently, actually. Really bad. Oh, excuse me. Yeah.
Rest in peace, John Hurt.
What happened to John Hurt?
He died.
Well, yeah, but recently.
I don't know, he brought it up because of Doctor Who, but I mean, he's barely a part of Doctor Who. He was in one thing.
Yeah, it was in the 50th anniversary special, which was good, but I feel like it was a bit wasted. There was too much new Who, not enough old Who, which was a bit of a shame.
I mean, it was a new Who episode, wasn't it? So that kind
of
makes sense.
It was supposed to be a celebration of like 50 years, and obviously it was the focus was on the more recent series, although they did sort of feature a lot of the older Doctors, though, kind of shoehorned in towards the end. It's a bit of a shame.
Why do you keep doing this?
So what's the 127 squadron, Alex? Is that something in particular, or just your squadron? Yes, he was the War Doctor, which was... It's kind of like a bit of a... shoehorn web, like replacing Mr. Eccleston to me. Do you not think? Like, because obviously he didn't want to come back and do it again because he was done with Doctor Who. Yeah. I mean, he was a good actor, obviously, but it was just a bit of a strange choice, if you ask me. Oh, it's you people. I started referring to the dude at the front of the Strangler's Guild. Oh, Tall Joe, because he was pissing me off with his tallness. I need to ask, are you two okay? You seem really stressed. I mean, we're normally quite stressed.
Clara's mum was played by the person who played Perry. Yeah, that was a nice little... And it was Clara's grandmother as well. They were both people, weren't they? And I think her mother, Clara's mother, was the voice of... Is it Knight Rider? Or is it the sat-nav in Knight Rider?
That was Kit. That was...
No, there isn't Kit. There's a female voice in something... It's not Knight Rider then, but it's something like Knight Rider. It's like, you have... Ah, no. She was a voice of a sat-nav that would take control of your car and drive you somewhere. What was that? Some of the earlier episodes.
Oh, the one in the Atmos episodes.
Yeah.
It was the sat-nav and the sort of ones with
She was the voice of the sat-nav.
Well, there you are. Fun facts of it.
Hoops, Snow Day, Rumble, Drop Shot. What's this new one called?
Guys, what's the new map called, guys? Let us know. We'll play some. Or is it a mode? New mode?
I think it's called Drop Shot. I think it's Drop Shot, but I'm not sure.
Give it a try. Perry just nodded with the accent and just went wide on when they tried to make an accent public, but the accent was actually American. Oh, interesting. Yeah, drop job.
So guys, password is GameHog, and password, yeah, name is password of GameHog.
Who was the real voice this app had? I don't know. Was there a fake voice?
I don't know. I'm sorry, John.
Yeah, I mean, Clara, I think she was in it for too long. She should have gone when she was supposed to. She shouldn't have stayed another series. That kind of dragged out her story to the point where it wasn't really that relevant anymore. Like, they finished the story off perfectly, and then I was like, oh, no, let's have more of her for no reason whatsoever. Seemed a shame.
Could you move that day nurse thing, by the way? I can't see the bottom right of the screen. Thank you. Want to hear a joke? Spammels. Good one.
Mean. Poor old Spammels.
I have a question. £1 million, but every person you see, you love a hair on your body permanently.
What?
That was really hard to read. And that cop-out where she died.
Yeah, I know, right? What was that? Like, that would have been the perfect ending for her. And then they're like, oh no, she's back now. Such a waste. Because obviously the actress was like, you know, I'm done, I'm quitting, I'm finished.
And they offered her more money or something.
No, then she changed her mind. They were already like writing the new series. She's like, I know, I want to come back. And they were like, okay, sure, let's write it back.
They should have gone, no, fuck off, you've had your chance. And now we don't have to try and shoehorn you into a series that probably won't do well.
Yeah. The problem being that Doctor Who has now predominantly been made a children's show. So obviously they have a lot of the Charles angle in it. And Clara, as a teacher, was the perfect jumping-off point for that. So it was a good way of them featuring more kids in it. Which is great for the kids, but I felt it made the storyline a lot more childish.
Well, also, it's not just kids. It's millennial young teens, isn't it? Especially the Tumblr generation, because they need that whole... It's the Steven Universe thing. And was it Osgood? Like, she's just on-the-nose representation of Tumblr.
I mean, she was just forced... Yeah, that was like... Tumblr personified.
Yeah, it was fucking irritating. I don't have to be one or the other. I can just be me. No, you have to be one or the other, because one of you are human, one of you are alien, and it does make a difference. It's not quite the same as being a transgender person. Stop trying to, you know, belittle something that is actually quite serious.
Indeed. I meant you lose a hair on your body permanently for £1 million. What, just one hair? Yeah, hell yeah.
That's a no-brainer.
Do you mean all the hair on my body? In which case, I'd still say probably yeah. I mean, I could pull off being bald. I can never stand Clara when she did that thing where she meets all the doctors. I felt that was symbolic of any Doctor fan writing herself and said, yeah, fanfiction. Yeah, it did feel like that. Oswin, yeah. Was it Oswin? Not Osgood?
No, it is Osgood, isn't it?
I'm pretty sure it was Osgood, but might be wrong.
Or is Osgood what she calls... Is one Oswin and one's...
Oh, it might be.
Wait. I need to sort this out in my head.
So, the one with the moon that has the spiders in was the worst episode, in my opinion. You know what, Mr. C? That had the potential to be such a great episode. But, Oh, is it not?
No, it is Osgood.
It is Osgood. Yeah, the one with the moon had the potential to be such a great episode. And it was all, like, all about Clara. It was like, It shouldn't have been. iPhone or Samsung? Samsung all the way.
Every day of the week.
iPhones are ridiculously overpriced for no good reason.
Do any of you guys know the YouTuber Jackmate?
Haven't heard of him.
Because I've been part of a discussion on YouTube, on Facebook, sorry. He's done this advert with his girlfriend for some wank app called Flipper. The app doesn't matter.
Mm.
But a friend of mine shared it going, is it just me or is this ad full of really sexist mansplaining banter? Mansplaining does my fucking head in, because basically it's women going, I don't like men telling me things I don't know. If a man does exactly the same tone of voice and like dialogue to another man, it's called being an asshole. It's not called mansplaining. Stop giving it a sexist name to make it like it's discriminatory when it isn't. But basically, I kind of went, would this have been mansplaining if it was performed identically with two blokes? And now people are saying, but it wasn't written for two blokes. And obviously two men wouldn't condescend each other. So it's a completely different advert. I don't know. What do you guys think? I kind of need to... I don't get it.
Fair point.
It was Clara Oswin Oswald. Oswin is the middle name.
Of course it was.
But she calls herself Osgood, doesn't she? Is that the one who... is Osgood maybe the one who was actually the...
The woman.
The alien.
Weren't there two of them?
Well, yeah, because there were the... What were they called? The fucking gross
Zygons.
Things? That's it.
Zygons.
And they wiped all their memories. I'm going to swear here, sorry. Fucking yes, oh my god, no, so many people and they all fucking say iPhone is nearly kill them. The iPhones are shit.
Yeah, iPhones are shit.
How could you hate them if they don't exist?
What do you mean?
You see the Temi plushie one of my viewers made? No, I didn't.
No.
Temi's slightly annoying, though. Like, she's... I don't like fans latching onto that one character and obsessing over them, and she is that. I think she's a nice addition, and it's nice to have that self-insert, but I don't like what... It's fans! Fans ruin everything.
Who's Temi?
She was one of the artists on Undertale, and so is in the game.
They didn't do that.
Yeah, they did.
That's like the one thing I can't stand when someone makes something, whether it be a film, a TV show, or a game, is inserting their own presence into it.
But you've not played Undertale, so you can't really comment. The entire game is filled with that kind of breaking of the fourth wall and all these kind of self-referential jokes in the same style that Earthbound is, and it's filled with all kinds of shit like that.
Even so, I hate it when it's done in any medium. Game, film, TV show. Like, cameos from directors or things like that. Come on, have some respect for yourself. Like...
No, I'd do it. If I was making a film, I'd put myself in a shop.
No.
It's my film. I want to be in it.
That pisses me off. Well, I have an iPhone and I've never used a Samsung, sort of saying it's rubbish to me, but I completely agree with what your point is. I mean, iPhones to me, I think, like, they're more of a status symbol more than anything else, because they do half what a Samsung can do for twice the cost.
What the fuck am I doing? How the fuck do you play this?
That's a good question, actually. Where are the goals?
There aren't any.
Huh.
Every time it bounces, it's... What?
Have you ever blocked slash hated a viewer before? We've hated lots of people. We've blocked a few, but
yeah,
mainly...
we've blocked a shit ton, but it's mostly people who self-promote. Yeah.
The games question. It said you hate the games and they don't exist. How could you hate something non-existent?
What?
Which games? Sorry, Mr. Tribo, you've lost me there. No, Tarantino put himself in Pulp Fiction and it worked.
Tarantino can really... Fuck off. I'm in a massive minority there, but I can't fucking stand him. I just hate his films. I think they're so pretentious. Some of them are alright. I don't like the decisions behind it. Like, what was that one? I've talked about it before. Was it Death Proof?
Yes, what about it?
That's just dog shit. And it's filled with pretentious, inverted commas, artistic decisions that just make me angry. Like, I think I mentioned this in a stream before.
Yeah, you did.
But he puts in deliberate continuity errors. And that, to me, is just a big middle finger to quality. Like, you can try and paint whatever fanciful bullshit you want. Like, oh, it's as an homage to the natural 50s films. You know, just get bent. It's a crap decision. You've basically put in something that's poor quality. And we're expected to go, oh, you're such a visionary director. You must have done this for great reasons. It's like you don't get a free pass for being who you are and making a shit decision. In the same way, Mario and Sonic, for being historically amazing, don't get a free pass for being shit just because they're Mario and Sonic. Same thing applies.
You kind of lost me there. I don't know what you're going about.
I was ranting.
Oh, I agree. £400-500 for a crappy phone that breaks easily, has a crappy camera. If you want a good phone, look for the Huawei P9/10. Has a lot of memory, better camera.
Yeah, the Huawei's are all right, I don't really like them. I feel like the main brands are just stronger and more reliable.
Intentional continuity errors. Were they intentional? I think they were intentional. I don't know.
They were intentional.
I mean, I'm a Tarantino fan. I think some of his films are weaker than other ones, but he certainly does do great work. I mean, no one can direct like him. He has very strong visions for films,
Seen all of his films, but from all the ones I've seen, I've never gone, that's definitely a Quentin Tarantino film. So I wouldn't really be able to go...
Which ones have you seen?
So I've seen Death Proof, I've seen... Grindhouse?
Planet Terror. I'd say those two are the weakest ones.
They are fucking dreadful. I hated them. I've seen the Kill Bill films. I've seen Inglourious Basterds. I've never seen Pulp Fiction, but I want to.
It's quite iconic, that one. Seen Django Unchained?
No. No interest. No interest in Hateful Eight either.
Hateful Eight was very good as well, actually. It was, would work very well as a play, and I think he is actually doing it as a play now, so that'd be interesting to see. How does this game work?
What? I thought that was me scoring.
So you have to, like, make...
It's got to bounce on the hexagons, and it's got to basically create an area that the ball can fall through.
Okay, fair enough.
Utter cack.
Hello, Aerotoaster. I'm well. How are you? Mario and Sonic, the fans that are triggered. Yeah, you're not wrong.
We're the only people that can see sense. No, we're the only people who can see beyond money and labels. Because everyone else buys iPhones because all their friends have them. I want to do it because I want to iMessage people and FaceTime. Why?
I mean, to be fair, mobile phones are ridiculously expensive. Like, it's become sort of normalised over the past few years. But, I mean, you are paying sort of £600 for a phone, which to me seems crazy.
Yeah.
Mystery soup, I fucked up my fault. I spell fast on my phone. Oh, I see. That's why the questions are coming out a bit strange. I think we should start making drinking games for videos every time Harry wears a new jumper, take a shot. Ha! You enjoyed my new jumper. Yeah, that was good. I wasn't sure about the pink, but the lady in M&S told me it would be a nice touch, so I believed her. You should see Reservoir Dogs there, since it's Tarantino's first film, my personal favourite.
I don't want anything to do with Quentin Tarantino. I don't want anything to do. I don't want to watch any more of his films. I find him a very, very unpleasant person as well.
Why is that?
Just watching him in interviews, I hate it. Is he autistic? He's very, like, some of his mannerisms are quite,
I think he's bipolar.
Is it bipolar?
I think so.
Fair enough.
I think, I'm not sure, don't quote me on that.
He comes across as very unpleasant in a lot of interviews. Did you ever see that famous clip of him about Django with Christian Guru Murphy?
Yes.
Who is a total cunt.
And he's like, I'm shutting your butt down.
Yeah, I'm shutting your butt down.
I mean, in his defense, it was BBC News, Quentin Tarantino was
Channel
a bit,
4.
Sort of, thank you, Channel 4. It was... He got worked up.
No, that's not the bit I find unpleasant, because he had every right to say that to someone who, if it's a boring, tedious subject that everyone keeps bringing up about race and violence and implications of that, and he had every right to get cross at him. It's not just that, it's other things like that. I just don't like the way he presents himself or comes across. I find him annoying and, generally unpleasant.
Yeah, to each their own.
Indeed.
No, I kind of thought Quentin Tarantino was, he actually was. He was a bit rude in that sense. It was BBC News. It was Channel 4 News. He could have just said, I don't want to answer this.
He did. The clip we saw was just the last bit when he kept pushing. And he goes, dude, I really don't want to talk about this. And you keep asking me. But the same guy, Krishnan Guru Murphy, again, did the Robert Downey Jr. one, where he made him storm out.
Again, that's the same thing. Is that Robert Downey Jr. could have said, I'd rather not answer that.
Dude, you have to, as a journalist, especially as someone who's been in the industry as long as Krishnan Guru Murphy, you have to be able to look at someone who you're interviewing, see how fucking distressed they are, and clearly getting more and more intense with their breath getting heavier as you progress through the conversation, to maybe go, would you prefer I didn't... And then they go, yes, thank you. And then you just move on. Sure, maybe he probably could have handled that a bit better, but he had every right to go, dude, what are we doing right now?
I don't know. I'd say the bottle's on both sides for that.
Yeah.
Welcome to the Rocket League. Start your engines and drop the beat. Hi, Aaron and Sean. Good to have you here. How's it going?
The N-word is forbidden. It shouldn't be allowed in here anyway. I put it on a list.
Yes, thanks, creeps, for blocking or deleting that. I wasn't going to say that out loud. I'm probably going to be banned by creeps.
I think it's Undertale's a lackless piece of shit with no story that makes sense.
Wow.
How did you?
With fire there.
I mean, Undertale is definitely bummed too hard by the internet, but it's written pretty well. It's got quite a lot of levels to it, which is what makes people like it. So I don't really necessarily agree with that.
Damn, dude! All I said was the scene with him in Pulp Fiction was pretty good. Yeah, I'd say that he was quite good. Those aren't the kind of cameos I'm talking about. What I mean is like when people. How do I put this right? If you're going to cameo, do something meaningful. Like, putting in, like, a small bit of yourself in a knowing way, kind of like a breaking the fourth wall kind of thing, that's what bugs me. Like, you know, when it's...
Like Signs.
Exactly like Signs. Well, actually, maybe not so much like Signs.
Actually, is Signs the example you want? You want them to be like that? Or is he too...
I don't mind if they give themselves, like, a role and they can play that role well. Like, Signs, yeah, he plays that character... He suits that role well.
So you don't like Peter Jackson being an on-screen moment of eating a carrot?
No, I mean, it's just... That's just like...
But that's less subtle. That's less on the nose.
No, that's what I'm saying. Is like I don't mind it if they're, you know, they're playing a role that they can play. Like, you know, if a director...
So you don't mind Peter Jackson eating a carrot because he could do that?
I've got to be honest, I haven't seen that, so I don't know what you're going on about.
You've never seen Lord of the Rings? He's in every film as a cameo.
Is he?
Yeah. He appears in one, like, if it's a shot... Oh, in the beginning of The Hobbit, as they enter Bree, You see a guy stumble up to the camera with a carrot, and that's Peter Jackson.
All right.
And then there's a guy on the boat when the ships are heading towards the final battle in Return of the King, and one of the guys on the boat is Peter Jackson.
And so what's the point? Like,
because then you can go, I made this film, and there I am. It's just a little thing. You're not going, I'm Peter Jackson. It's just a little thing for you, which I think would be quite cool, to be able to go, I made this, and look, I'm right there.
Yeah,
no,
but do you think you'd be maybe like, oh, look, I made this. There's my name. This is directed by.
That's not the point. No, that's not the point. It's beyond that. It's like, I have presented this and made it, but at the same time, I got to be in it.
I don't know. To me, that feels a bit self-indulgent.
But yeah, I mean, isn't the entirety of the movie industry massively self-indulgent?
Not so much.
No?
I think there are plenty of directors who, you know, make great films and don't feel the need to star in them or, you know, put themselves in it.
Yeah.
They're happy with themselves.
Yeah. But that doesn't detract from when people do it. There's not that many examples of ones who do it and who make a complete arsehole of it.
I mean, like Quentin Tarantino example in Django Unchained. That was just the worst example of that whatsoever.
Did he actually put himself in it?
He puts himself in it as a defined role, quite a big role, and he just doesn't act well. And he stands out like a sore thumb. How do we get out, says Spamels? Hi, Spamels, why should I get out? Yeah, like he puts on this really bad Australian accent and he just stands out. And again, there's no need. Spamels. Yes, hello, Spamels. Everyone's saying hello to Spamels. Anyway. Oh, bloody hell. Those emails building up. Sorry about that, just have to check my emails sporadically for any things coming in. Savage Spamels. It's not that savage, really. It's alright. Ooh. So can you fall through the floor in this now, or not?
No.
Okay, well, that's good.
There it is. What?
It's really great to me when people fake an Aussie accent. Yep, I'll give you that. Oh, of course, you're from Australia, aren't you? So, have you seen Django Unchained? Have you seen his awful accent? Can you give us the lowdown whether it was a good accent or not? Oh, because I'm not down with Tolkien. Yes. Well, I'm sorry I don't know every actor from Lord of the Rings.
No, it doesn't, Alex. It's fine.
Spouse, can you honestly tell me that the Hobbit films were necessary? Could they have not just done one good one? Did they have to do a trilogy of 3.5 hour long films?
They
really?
could have easily done it in the original thing that they said they were doing, which was 2, and frankly, it would have been way better for it. Cramming it all into 1 would have been too much. Cramming it into 3 is way too many, so do it in 2. Just cut out the middle.
Wow, the Game Hog chat on the stream is super delayed today, is it?
I can't do anything about it either. It's literally just a web link that'll do what it does. Sometimes it's earlier than that, sometimes it's later.
Nah, thanks, Spammers. Love you too, babes. I'll tell you what, let's do an experiment here. I'm gonna say a number and we're gonna time how long it takes to
appear. There's no point because it'll change in the next 10 seconds to what it was now, and then in 20 minutes it'll change. It's depending on bandwidth, which right. At the moment we seem to be fine with.
Who's quickest to type the number?
In fact, we're doing the best. We haven't dropped a single frame, so
69. Type really 69 sure in the comments now. Let's see what we get.
It'd probably just be 11.
Sighting. So it's showing up in the chat, on our live chat. It's taking a long time. Okay, there we go. So that took 30 seconds to show up on the live chat. Yeah, wow.
Jesus.
That is long, yeah. Thanks for that, guys. Appreciate it.
Oh, well.
That seems long, wow.
There's nothing we can do.
The Hobbit trilogy is my favourite trilogy. I freaking love it. Ah, fine. Well, I'll tweet to their own.
So, more so than Lord of the Rings. Are you high?
You crazy, Spells! You crazy! Surely not, Spamels. Surely not.
Don't get me wrong, I enjoyed the Hobbit films, but they weren't... They definitely weren't as good on, like, an objective level. They were made worse, they were written worse. presented slightly worse.
Spammels, you're in a minority here. Back to the Future, a close second. Why isn't that first? That's a great trilogy. What else is good? I don't know. Good trilogies.
Jurassic Park.
Jurassic Park.
I liked Jurassic Park 3. Everyone else hated it. I liked it. It was fun. It was shit.
Never didn't like Brave, but the fourth one. My God. That was atrocious. And now they're doing like a fifth and sixth one.
Of course they are.
Hobbit was way more fun, more varied in comedy and drama. Huh, fair enough. I only ever saw the first one, so I can't comment really.
It was a bit more varied, but I think that was what made the Lord of the Rings moments of comedy so much better, is they weren't like... Most of the jokes in The Hobbit are, haha, that dwarf's fat and does things that fat people shouldn't do, like run quickly. You know, it's a bit, it's not that clever, but some of the moments, especially, basically Martin Freeman is the saving grace of that film, but everyone else, not so much. I prefer Lord of the Rings for their moments of humour.
Bye, Alex Lines. Thanks for stopping by. Appreciate it.
See you, Alex. Yeah, I'm done playing this one. Sorry, Yana.
Yeah, it seems tricky, this one. Oh, sorry, guys. I'm a bit out of energy today.
Indeed.
Long day.
Oh, fuck's sake.
Disney didn't do too bad with Star Wars. I applaud them with it.
I agree.
Yeah, they did a good job.
Learned some new stuff about Episode 8 as well, for those of you who are interested.
Oh, yes. That's,
best trilogies are The Dark Knight. Definitely not. Original Star Wars. Yeah, Back to the Future and Lord of the Rings.
Okay, so I don't really agree with you there. I think the second Dark... Well, the film, The Dark Knight, was fantastic. Brilliant. But Batman Begins was very strange. And Dark Knight Returns? That was just bizarre. Mm. And the shallow sort of... utilitarian points they tried to make in it weren't that deep at all. And, you know, the plot lines made no sense and seemed to contradict each other. So,
Yo, bitches, what's your favourite Rick and Morty song? Mine's Moon Men or Rick Dance. I prefer Moon Men. I was part of a cover of that with Shady Box, if you guys want to check it out.
Don't I get swifty? Oh, my phone's ringing. Later, bitches.
That's right, Yana. Thanks for playing with me. Yo, bitches. Well, I won't begin a debate about the Star Wars saga. Do you guys want to hear some Star Wars... Wait. Shut that door. Shut the door. Sorry, that was a moment. So do any of you guys want to hear some motivation / tiny spoilers for Star Wars Episode 8, which I've recently found out? The best Batman movie is the Lego Batman movie. I've heard it's really good. I really, really want to go see that. That's all. Okay. God, the chat really goes silent sometimes, doesn't it? Nope. What just happened? It just completely crashed. I'm on the PC now. Great, Spammels. Would you like to play something else? Sorry, everyone. I'm tired and can't be fucked with this today, and so I'm, like this. I would just like to say the best trilogies are Back to the Future, Jurassic Park, and the original Star Wars movies. I'm glad you can enjoy those, Toaster. Mystery Soup is back. Where did Mystery Soup come from as a name? What's your best trilogy, Ed? I don't think I've ever watched a film long enough to enjoy it for more than one. So I don't know. I can't think of any trilogies I like. Maybe, okay, the original Lord of the Rings trilogy. The Hobbit, number one. Back to the Future, number two. Star Wars, meh.
Sorry about that.
You're a weird one, Spammels.
What's the chat? Which is still on trilogies, I see.
What the hell is going on? I have no sound on my YouTube on PC.
I think that's
sounds like a
end.
Problem on your end.
OMG, it is when you liked me. There you go, Spammels. High praise indeed.
Anyway, I have to go now. Sorry it was short, but I should be able to come back next Tuesday. All right, Alex, see you later. Have fun at REF.
Good to see you, buddy. Thanks for stopping by. Hi, Emerald Rarity. Haven't seen you in a while. How are you doing? Doing well?
You saw Mystery Soup sound like a memorable channel name, and it wasn't taken. And yeah, I made videos once upon a time. Why don't you make them anymore?
Best trilogies? That's a good question.
I really like The Guardians of the Galaxy. Can't wait for Volume 2. Yeah, I mean, all these films are like ones where I look at it and go, oh, I really want to see that, and then realise I'm never going to go and pay to go and watch it in the cinema. I'm just going to wait for it to come out on Netflix. But I do really want to see that. Iron Man trilogy. Dude, come on!
Actually, that's a good point. The second one wasn't so good, but the first and third ones were very good, so I'll give you that.
I like the first one. What the fuck happened in Iron Man 2?
So the second one was kind of a letdown. He's kind of dying due to his toxicity, you know.
Oh, yeah.
And he has to develop the new element.
And at the same time, fuck me, I remember it.
At the same time, Mickey Rourke is playing that kind of crazy guy who's trying to make his own
with the electric whips
for the other guy.
Yeah.
It's got some good moments in it. The third one, that was very good indeed. I like that. Especially with Ben Kingsley as the Mandarin, that was a great casting choice.
What else happened in that film? We had those guys with the weird powers who could explode.
Which one?
In the third Iron Man movie.
Oh, the third one, yes. There were the ones with the virus, whatever it's called, that, yeah, could power themselves up and be really hot and stuff. And of course, yes, there is that annoying bit where he goes and spends time with the kid.
I like
that
bit.
He's an annoying kid.
I like that bit. I think the kid's really likable. I normally hate kids in those things, but actually I quite liked him. The three films explore three different emotions. Playboy, film two, scared of death, film three, grows up. Which one was the one post-Avengers and he's having loads of flashbacks? Because I liked that they did that.
Third one.
Yeah, I liked that they did that. It just made sense and you actually saw a moment of introspective flashbacks of I flew through a fucking portal with a nuclear bomb over my own city to a different galaxy. And you guys expect me to just process this like it was nothing. And actually, that's the first time I've ever seen them reference that, which I thought was really, really clever. I have a question for all the Hogs. Watching rock or house music? If it's between those, it's rock music any day of the week, because house music is a very dull drum beat with a specific type of synthesizer with no dynamics whatsoever.
I concur. Speaking of winning things on Netflix, I'm waiting for Sherlock Season 4 to be out on Netflix, and each season is basically a trilogy of movies. They go for at least 1-2 minutes.
Don't waste your time.
Yeah, the fourth season of Sherlock was a bit of a letdown. I'd exercise caution for that.
I liked Thor the first one, but the second one wasn't as good as the first. The second one was cack, but I'm looking forward to Ragnarok, because Ragnarok's a really cool event in Norse mythology.
Yeah, plus it's based on Planet Hulk from the comics, which is a great sort of road trip kind of comic thing.
Film three, he really realises the darkness in the world and how actions have consequences and one can't just recklessly go about unchecked. And that's part of the motivations for Civil War, which actually loads of people slammed, and again, I quite liked. It had the motivations made sense, had some bits that were a bit superfluous, but I really enjoyed that.
Music's a bit loud, apparently. Yes, Mammals, you're right. I mean, Sherlock, the problem with it was, the first season was really good, and it was sort of him with no emotion, and it was kind of the one-off mysteries, and they were great. And the second season was sort of that as well, but by the time you get to the third season, you kind of have to go somewhere with the character. You can't just do that all the time. He has to grow. He has to develop as a person. And the problem was the way they did that was sort of making this overarching story that involved, you know, his not just his brother, but also the other Holmes person. Spoilers, you know, not really going deep into it. And they went the wrong way about it. They added too much in and, the focus on Martin Freeman's character and his wife was... I didn't understand why they went so deep on it.
Because the focus is on Watson in the Sherlock Holmes novels.
No, but the focus is on his wife, though. And it's all on... I can't remember the name right now.
Want to know something Watson does twice as much as Sherlock in the entire... Or is it 10 times? Something that he does that much more times throughout all of the novels? Ejaculates. But not in the sense of sex, in the sense of writing. It means to exclaim something. And so many times in the original Arthur Conan Doyle novels, you'll just find, what? He ejaculated.
Hi, Carvick Silver. How's it going?
Mary Watson.
Yeah, thank you. Yeah, Watson. Yeah, Mary. Because I never believed her as the secret agent, which is what she was supposed to be. you know, great actress, she's fantastic in other things, but she was not believable in that role at all. And that just kind of, I couldn't buy her as that, and that kind of ruined it for me. At least they are passable sequels, only one movie. What do you mean, Yana, sorry, do you mean the Iron Man ones, or do you mean...
No, she means that she can't think of many good trilogies, but there are some films with passable sequels, so there are only two of them.
I see. Sherlock Holmes with Robert Downey Jr., they were quite good. And that was a case where the first film was good and the second film was also quite good. Sort of quite impressive.
I've never got through the second one. It's one of those... I've started it about 20 times and I've always fallen asleep because I really liked the first one. Mm. But no, I don't think I've ever gotten through the second one.
And the article making film for it has been delayed quite a bit because obviously he's busy doing Avengers stuff and Iron Man stuff.
I'm so bored of it now. Yeah, we did see the Spider-Man trailer, by the way, someone asked, and...
That was me.
It looks alright. And it's...
I'm excited to see Spider-Man as part of the Avengers, but I just hope they don't retread the same ground that's been done so many times before. I don't think they will. I have hope. I think it's going to be quite good.
Fun fact, in the Phoenix Wright series, I made a couple of prequel games which include Sherlock Holmes. All of the chapters are based on stories in the original Holmes book series. That's pretty cool.
That's quite good.
They did sort of do that with the second episode of the third season. It was two mysteries. How did the killer get in, stab the man, and leave without a trace? That's the same plot as Ace Ventura. My mother walked in when you said sex. She yelled at me and asked what you said. Then a few seconds later, you said ejaculate. And she was like, what the fuck? I did immediately say, not in the sexual sense, in the grammatical sense. But if your mother's funny with grammar, then...
Explain that to her.
Yeah. Yeah, the actor was really nice, but I was really disappointed by the second movie.
What, I mean, Sherlock Holmes?
Again, I can't comment on it. I never got through it.
It was a good idea. I think, you know, it was more arty. It was Rice and Mac Pools. I thought it was good. Music's quite, interesting to know. Should we play a game of some kind?
Yes, I suppose we should.
What should we play, guys? Let us know. What I liked was the Professor Layton games were very good. So those kind of mystery solving games, puzzle solving games, I like those a lot. Sort of very similar to Sherlock Holmes, I guess, but yeah, it was good. I enjoyed those.
Howdy, Mr. Tom, how's it going?
Hi, Mr. Tom.
Left 4 Dead? Fuck no. Most sequels are worse than the original. Yep, best example to prove the opposite, A Lord of the Rings, hands down Harry Potter. But that's not true, because Fellowship of the Ring is definitely one of the better films in the trilogy, because it establishes everything really well. Let's play a game. Yeah, let's.
Spammers is mocking our lack of energy. Sorry, Spammers, we'll be really energetic for you, babes. Oh, yeah. Energy, game hog.
Watching the Sherlock being shipped would make worse with Watson ejaculating in front of Sherlock.
Rotten mouse.
Perhaps. Professor Layton versus Ace Attorney is the best, in my opinion. One of the most amazing plot twists I've seen in a game.
Oh, did that come out? I was following that. I never actually played in the end. Yeah, I'll just check that one out. That sounds quite good.
Play Quiplash.
Who's Skyping me? Updates. Quiplash? Yeah.
Yeah.
Let's do it. Harry gets too excited. Trash the mouse. That's... yeah. Yeah, Professor Layton, that original trilogy was so good, and such a sad ending as well. Like, it was such a good storyline. You know, even though it was just like a storyline written around puzzle solving. So good. Like, especially, you know, the last one, the third one. Brutal. Brutal.
Trashing the mouse sounds like a sex act. Euphemism for masturbation.
What sex act would that be? Yeah, there you go. Alright.
So does mystery soup. Not really. That sounds like a term for ejaculate.
Okay, here we go. Jackbox. You getting in on this or...?
Nah.
Alright, here we go. Who's up for Quiplash, guys? Jackbox.tv, put in the code HAWB and let's play. Spammers. What does... That's not a sex act. How could that be a sex act?
Ah, the Cleveland Steamer.
What's a Cleveland Steamer? Oh, that's one. Oh, be cool. Be cool. Two more slots, guys. Who's getting involved?
What's up, Blanky Git?
Yeah, Lost Future. Brutal, wasn't it? Absolutely brutal.
Sorry, mate. Tired. How are you?
Yeah. Especially with Luke at the end. It's just so sad. Okay, Mr. Tom's in. One more slot if anyone's interested. I know we got quite a small audience today, but... Nero's in. Wonderful. Let's go for it, guys. Remember, funny, not blue.
Oh shit, what's up? I want to get a steam machine, call it the Cleveland Steam Box.
Very good, very good.
You really seem to need a good holiday, fucking yeah.
Is it that obvious? Alright.
Let's go into a trance. I'm bored, mate, I'm tired, and I've got a whole fucking evening of band practice tonight that I just don't want to have to do. Can I be offensive? We are.
Sure.
Cunt. See? We're offensive. Do whatever you want.
We're trying to be funny offensive.
Oh, yeah. Shit. Ah!
What?
There. It's over.
Hi, Lord Yoshi. How's it going? Lloyd Yoshi, rather.
You guys ever play Switch? Yes. Don't know how else to say that. We've got some stuff on the channel. Band practice. I didn't know you started that up again. It's not my band, it's my mates, but I play for them during the live shows. Who likes Mein Kampf? Dude, come on. So you're going on vacation soon? No, that was someone saying we look like we need a vacation soon.
Which is true. Eh. 420 MLG blaze it. Game of Nazi confirmed. Great.
Oh yeah, Kenny G, shut up. Vacation with me starts next Friday, where I'm doing fuck all but revising for your first year of university, which you don't need to do well in. Stop working so hard. You're a student in your first year of uni. You should be doing the bare minimum. Oh, damn. Well, I had 5 weeks of relaxing and finding myself, and it wasn't enough. I see.
Game Hog of Terrace as well. Shit. You caught us. Oh, dear me.
Okay, next one. The most boring graffiti you could see in the subway. Time to vote.
Yeah, one of these is mine. Sorry. Oh. Tired. I know. Did anyone see the new Ghostbusters film? I haven't obviously seen it, because I have no desire to, but was it as bad as people said it was? Yeah, better. Well, I missed some. Off to Thailand for the ladies. Bye, Spammels.
Thanks, hey, Spammels. Bye. Thanks for coming.
Appreciate it.
The terrorists were always going to win.
The first thing you would do after winning the lottery. Vote on your devices.
Yep.
Ed, you're a big fan of Markiplier. Do you have any opinions on his recent vid on the pitfalls of YouTube success? It was interesting. I actually think Markiplier is a way more complex character than he allows out for people to see. He's actually... It's not dissimilar to me in a lot of ways. Like, he quite clearly gets frustrated with people quite a lot. And you can see that in so many of his things. When he doesn't think something's funny on something he's collabing with, and he's clearly in a mood, you can see him directly be like, no, and just say that to people. And I think after the amount of success he's had and the amount of fucking irritating fans he's got to have. It's going to be filled with downfalls, and it's going to make you feel a bit lost and listless. It's a bit shitty that he's feeling that way, but, yeah. I don't know, I think everything, he obviously never expected to get as big as he did, and for him to be struggling with it, and maybe finding himself a bit lost for what to do, I'm not surprised, it was always going to happen.
But do you seem that tired, really? Yana, I appreciate your concern.
How will you cope with it when you blow up? We won't. That's an easy way to deal with it.
Yeah, he's got to get one send clothes.
I mean, an instantly funny one would have just been a mashing of words. After the whole Matt and Ryan incident, I've tuned out of Markiplier. Actually, creeps, so have I. Ever since that, on a subconscious level, I have paid way less attention to him. And I'm starting to see a side of him I don't like. And he's not making a lot of content anymore. The stuff he is making is all a bit shit. I don't know where he's going. I don't know where the future of YouTube as a whole is going. I don't know where all of these people are going to be in 2 years from now, let alone five. So, I don't know. The whole Matt and Ryan thing really put me off him because obviously I have a huge amount of respect for Mark and Matt and Ryan subsequently. And the fact that he treated them so badly just really fucks me off. What happened with Matt and Ryan? So Matt and Ryan, who are the guys from Super Mega, or Kids with Problems, or Syndigo, for those who don't know them, they used to work for Markiplier as his editors, because they were friends and they did some sketches together for a while, so he thought, we work really well, why don't I pay you guys to be my editors? So they came on board and they did it, but the thing is, he's an asshole, and he's really draconian, and there's all this stuff that we don't see behind the scenes of him not being like, that's not good enough, you need to do this again, you need to do more stuff like this. And after enough time, they basically went, dude, we can't do this anymore. Like, it's not fun working for a friend, and when your friend is acting like this, how fun is that for a relationship? And then they kind of just, they left, and then they started working for Game Grumps. And I don't think those guys talk anymore, because you don't hear them mention each other at any point. And actually, the Grumps don't talk about Mark anymore. I think Mark has actually isolated himself recently. And I don't know why, I don't know what's going on. But it's a sad state of affairs that our, you know, most beloved personalities on the platform are slowly dying. I like how much he experiments on his channel, but to be honest, I don't really like the new team. Seems like such a forced, fun atmosphere. I've always hated Ethan from Crank Gameplays. I find him about as funny as a cactus down the japs. But, like, Tyler I quite like, but I don't get a lot of their things to... Like, I can't express how annoying I find Ethan. Jacob Jones. I love these guys so much. They need more subs. Thank you, Jacob. That's very Jacob. Kind of you.
Oh, dear. Oh, no, you click refresh by accident. Sorry to hear that.
Apparently, Danny posted a throwback Thursday picture of him and Mark a couple of months ago, but yeah, they seem a lot more distant. It's pretty sad, to be honest. I just passed my exam, so now I'm going to the ninth. That is, that this has been Positive Ed and Game Hog. Okay, I'm really gone now.
Thanks, Spammels.
What just happened? Bye, Spammels. Well done, Dat Boy.
Yes, Mr. Tom, in fact, I booked the table today. I'm just about to pay for it. God knows how much it'll cost. Probably quite a lot of money, it always does. Yeah, guys, it's our last chance to think about doing merch. So, posters, wristbands, what do we think? Would there be enough interest? Because, like, it's probably quite a lot of money. We see that people are going to buy them, that's all.
To be honest, I'm missing Tits McGee, but you can't get everything you want in life. Don't worry, mate, there's 10 whole episodes for you to go and binge watch if you need more Tits McGee in your life.
Oh, yeah.
Also, there's quite a lot of Tits McGee... his personality in today's video.
True.
Guess whose new strings arrived today? This guy. Nice. I never really liked Mark, to be honest. Really? Interesting. We can't sell shirts, Mr. Tom, I'm afraid.
Well, we could do, but the problem is like we have to get more prints ahead of time, and that means like guesstimating how many large, medium, and small we need. It's just very difficult. I was chatting to a man about it, you know, from Ed's World, and he says, yeah, I mean, unless you're selling big numbers of them, then it's really worth it. I mean, even he doesn't sell that many of them. And that's Ed's World, and they're huge. So for us to sell them would just be very tough.
Tom, if you want a shirt, you can buy one on our merch store. We're just not going to be selling them in person.
Yeah.
Is there a remote chance that Game Hog would be taken to the sea on Blackwake? If Spam wasn't here, then no. I'm with... They have too many inside jokes. There's stuff you can only laugh about with friends that wouldn't be funny to anyone else. I always like when Bob visits Mark. They have good chemistry together. Yeah, Bob, Mark, and Wade and Jack are always... Their stuff together is very fun to watch. Luckily, they don't involve Ethan, because I really, really just... He's always doing that... You know when you're a child and when you're trying to tell your friend something that's funny, you kind of do that thing where you're on the edge of laughing, everything you're about to say? He sounds like he's on the edge of laughing with everything he's about to say, and I've never heard him say one thing that's remotely amusing. And that fucks me off. We could do Guns of Dickerus. Could do Guns of Dickerus if you fancied. It's voting time.
Oh, yeah. I might have to get chat down in a second. Let me finish running a quick bash, and then I'll leave you guys to play some games with Ed.
People who ship Mark and Ethan actually terrify me. People do that. I'm always ready to pilot chaps. Well, I've heard that, mate. You do love men.
Gotta be honest, anyone shipping anything scares me.
I agree. What?
I don't get it.
Yeah, well, shipping is sad and weird.
I get it, but I don't think it's
just sad and weird. It's the only way of putting it. Picking the let one, it's a paradox. Does your computer have an internet browser and connection? If so, you go on rule 30... You mean rule 34 and check GameHog.
What? Are you just saying that because there's the implication that there's porn of everything?
I wonder if there is porn of us on rule 34.
I doubt there is. We're not big enough to have that. I hope.
Boy, can you really not access Rule 34?
You can, but there's just no website for it. At least not anymore. A bad name
for a brand of bottled water. Okay, it's gone.
We can just Google Game of Rule 34. Your devices. I doubt that exists, though.
Pigs. Okay, we're not doing that.
Well, that is fair. I mean, our name is Game Hog.
Final Fantasy 15.
But EdX Spammels? No EdX Spammels. That boy, that's quite a serious question there. Co-ed schools are only boys slash girls schools. Well, I say co-ed schools are the best because it allows you to integrate with people of the opposite sex at a young age, which is important to your growth and development. I think boys or girls only schools gives you a very narrow-minded view of the world and is not helpful.
For some reason, we were restricted to sixth form only, so I didn't get girls at my school till I was 16. At least not anymore. Lol, good experience. Well, look at me, I got shipped so much I got a boyfriend out of it. Sort of. Wait, did fail shut down? What's fail?
What is fail?
Or is that feel?
I'm not sure.
We've had this talk before, but in my opinion, shipping is fine as long as you don't insult the people involved, for example, by shoving an explicit X-rated fan art in their face. But who's doing that anyway? That's weird. Why do we turn around and go, oh, that's fine? But if you wrote, like, a really intense fanfiction about me, I'd just be a bit like, that's weird. Like, what have you done? I don't mean jokey, silly ones, but if you've actually done one that's like, you poured time and soul and effort in it, what are you doing with your life? You just need to reevaluate.
I mean, if it's fictional characters, I mean, I get why people do it. It's a bit weird, but you know, whatever. But if it's with real people and they don't know you've done it, or even if they are aware you've done it, but you didn't do it without their permission, isn't that a bit weird that you've done that to people?
How much do you have to donate to become a mod? You're never going to become a mod now, Kenny G. You're on our never get modded list. Don't use donations as bribery. Creeps laying down the law.
R.I.P. Club Penguin. Yeah, indeed, that's shutting down tomorrow, isn't it? that.
Right.
12 years of miserable friendship, Kenny. You bring that dank pea costume again. Yep, he's in the corner over there.
What you did.
Still gonna get more use out of him.
Okay, in round three, you get to award three votes. You can give them all to one answer.
I remember someone tried to bribe Queen for mod status on her stream. $50 gone.
Wait, was that you, Yug Yug? Dear me. So, something that is currently legal that should be banned. Humping donkeys, underpants, arsing to be moles, twerking, shipping, closing down Club Penguin, weeding shit. People who bring loud babies out in public. Yes, that's bad.
There's not enough proper ones on here. Asking to be mod, definitely. That should be number one.
Yeah, that's quite a good one, actually.
It's like that. I also wrote some fan fiction in my time about characters of a series, explicit stuff, but it's a fan thing. It's for me and those who share my interest. I would never tell the cast. Yeah, Rule 34 is weird. People call me weird for being wolfkin, panton sexual, and bestly, but I'm always telling them to go to hell. Those fucking queer fascists. I hate middle school and all of these people.
I'm guessing you're joking, right, Kenny G? That's that thing you do.
I'm assuming so.
You joke.
Who watches anime?
He does.
Some shows. Walking too slowly during commutes.
That's pretty unforgivable.
It's just been made legal.
Please watch anime. There you go.
It's over. Let's take a look at the final scores.
I'm drudging. There's nothing trudging about Full Metal Alchemist Brotherhood. That's a fucking experience. Enjoy every second of it.
Did some kind of anime series just end recently?
No.
I saw that
Naruto
picture of what's his face crying.
For Neverworld. Yeah.
Yes, him.
Yeah, that was. I don't know why the fuck he thought it. He's a fucking ugly guy at the best of times. Why he thought posting the most ugly picture of himself ever as a selfie when he was crying to say thank you Naruto for so many years. I don't need to see that you're crying, dude.
Right, I need to put the job on and do some work. You want some game of this or are you going to play something else?
We could do some Guns of Icarus and then when you're back at the end we'll do another one.
Cool, let's do that. Right guys, I'll be back in a bit, hopefully sooner rather than later, but I'm not sure how long it'll be. I'll see you in a bit. Bye, dude.
Another round. We'll do another round later. Right. So, it's time for us to jump in and do some other games. Go away, Quiplash. I'm done with you. Right, let me just open up Discord. Excuse me. Right. What am I even playing? Guns of Icarus. Right. There we go. Sorry, just having to turn some stuff up. Play. Why is that not coming up on my screen? Right, that should be done. There we go. Say hi to Dave for me. He's next door. How much swag does Ed have? I'm too much swag. I am the swag. I are the swag. I remember seeing this Yahoo Answers post. Someone was asking how they could give us, how they could give their child Naruto whiskers. One of her plans was to make small incisions into the baby's cheek. That woman needs to have the child taken away from her. That's not okay.
Right.
All right.
Oh, there you are.
Here I am. How are we all doing?
I'm good. Man?
Right, let me invite you all.
Let me actually get into the game.
That would probably be smart. Join crew. Your friend is not running a match. Okay.
Check off. Oh, there it is.
Best part of playing with is I get to stop watching the stream.
Yes. Nice. Fuck you.
How's the stream going, Ed? I dropped in about 40 minutes late.
It's going all right.
I don't get how Guns of Icarus can run fine on this laptop, but Blackwake can't.
No, I know, right? Guns of Icarus...
Well, Blackwake's
used to
appallingly
one
of optimized.
Yeah, that is true.
To my crew, by the way.
Smashing.
Mine's still loaded.
I'm in the crew. The left ball. That was the name of my my ship. The Blauchob and the left ball.
Yeah. I need to change the... Let me have a look.
Yeah, let's fiddle with the ship.
Yeah, we did something dumb to the ship.
Oh, we took something off, didn't we?
Yeah, I think we swapped out a weapon for a new one, which is objectively worse.
It's running fine because it's not too close to the sun. Shut up, Mystery Soup, you dick.
Oh, come on, load!
Yeah, so it runs fine, but it takes forever to load.
Yeah.
Right. Okay, I don't know how long you'll be. Because it'll probably take an extra hour on top of that for us to actually get into a game.
Yeah, exactly. Don't worry, it does this every time I try to boost it.
Butt face. Thank you, Dad Boy.
Let me try, actually, closing all of this.
Oh shit, what up, it's Dad Boy.
Oh shit, what up, it's Dad Boy. One man. One desire.
It always takes longer than I'd like it to.
At least it's doing all right for quite a small game.
Yes.
Are we waiting for Queen, or should we just start looking?
We are just waiting for Queen at the moment.
Well, I'll start searching, because God knows we'll have enough time.
Can we still invite her while we're looking? Okay,
well, unless someone fills our crew, in which case they can...
Oh, yeah, fill my crew. Off. Right, Queen Creeps has logged in. So, invite. Invite to crew. There we go, and also invite to party. Accept those invites, Creeps. Look, it's called Guns of Icarus. I'm a big fan of different mythologies. These jokes are easy for me to make and look smarter than I am.
Yeah.
Clash at Blackcliff. We're waiting.
What is that?
You've gone offline, Creeps.
I know, I'm going back online.
How long's that gonna take? It took you an hour to get in here.
Oh, see, I was right. I closed my entire browser thing, which accidentally closed Discord, rebooted it, and it just started straight away.
Right.
So give me 2 seconds whilst it connects to the lobby, and then I will get in.
I don't believe you.
I'm getting in the game! It's loading now! There we go, the Temps invites you to play.
There we go, right, we're in. Ready up, J-Lo.
Hey.
Ah, shit. How fucking long are we going to be waiting in here?
The Blauchob.
Yes.
We just need an entire crew and then we're good.
I could try and find a more appropriate one.
Yeah, sure.
Might as well. But anything that gets us in there as quick as possible. Two jackals of 10.
Match list. We have all of 4 matches to choose from.
Hooray!
Yay!
Spoiled by choice.
So I chose this one because it's the fullest.
Right, okay. Hang on. Can you invite me, Johnny?
We're not even in it. God.
Well, get in it!
It filled up captains. 3 out of 4 captains, 16 out of 13 players. That's not good.
No.
Ah, here we are. Right. Invites to all.
I've not received anything. I'm yet to... There it
is.
There
they are. Invite, oh, no. It's...
I haven't got one.
Well, we're not friends, so that's why.
Oh.
Wait, it... It didn't work. You'll have to send me another one.
You're
oh, no,
in,
wait,
dude.
You're in. Shit. No. We're on different
swap
ships.
Swap slots with someone on one of my slips. You can right click and swap.
What
if not,
I
then I'll just have to repeatedly kill you.
What do I do?
I right clicked and hit swap slot. It's not working.
Invite her in. Quick, invite queens.
Invite to crew. Okay, I've invited you to crew. Johnny, you may have to swap with one of mine.
Ooh.
Did it work?
Did you... Are you in?
I clicked your invite. It hasn't moved me anywhere.
You may have to do it again.
Well, invite me again.
I can't.
What do you mean you can't?
I can't. It's not work. I can invite you to my party. I can't invite you to the crew. Oh, now you're in. Start the match in 30 seconds. No, Johnny!
Johnny, what are you doing?
Johnny, can you swap for a Ho Beer Boom or something?
I've sent a message to William of Orange.
Wait, am I even in?
Yeah, you're in. Don't worry.
Oh, okay. Oh
no, we're going to be on totally different teams. This isn't fun.
It's fun because I'm going to get to watch you die.
Play some CSGO betting. Definitely not.
I can't see it, so who's on whose team? Oh, there we go.
Oh no, Johnny.
It's fine, dude. We'll be all right.
I don't want to play this if you're not on the same team.
I don't want to live without you, Ed, but we'll make it. We'll make it if we try. Just the one
two.
Of us.
Yeah, just it's, two of it's us against one of you. Oh, wonderful. All right, Hogs, I need to go. I'll be back later. All right, Toaster, catch you laters.
What a lovely fan base. It's always refreshing and nice to log on every stream and seeing the subscriber count tick up.
Yes, it is. And we've actually been fucking growing. Yeah. Eat my balls. We're completely aware of the fact that we've never
That wasn't
ever,
your fault,
ever
though. That was YouTube.
Yeah, it was shitty. There was one day where we lost 800 subs.
Oh god, who's on this team?
800.
Oh good, the ship I actually let go of.
That was when we were about 5 away from 2,000, so that was at a point where it was fucking unbearable.
Oh, shit, we're
trying to pop. Balls are literally shriveling up inside me just hearing those numbers.
What numbers?
Your fucking
yeah, I know, son. Right? It kills you inside. It's like when PewDiePie loses, he lost 300,000 subs in a day once, and like that could make someone's career.
Yeah.
Just that number of people, it's so fucking terrifying.
I love the I love the maps in here, like this battleship. It's like, how did that get there?
Oh, crap. Are we like... Four guns. Are we...
Man, oh, the fucking four guns, you prick!
Ow, 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 ow.
Oh, I can't even see the F...
I can't even see the guns!
It's because it's this side that's...
What the fuck? Queen Krebs, get on the fucking front gun. Oh, dear,
it will when you don't call me Queen Krebs.
This guy just keeps chatting. Shut up, dude.
Dude, I don't even...
Oh my god.
Nice ram, dude.
I can't even...
Oh, Johnny, that's you! You're the blow job!
Yes, I know. My repairman is like... Get on the guns, guys. Come on.
This is hilarious to watch. Oh, dude,
burn,
I'm destroying your guns.
Right, I'm gonna have to just go on this.
Reload, 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 reload. Yeah, I destroyed your flaming gun. Oh, yeah.
Oh, bollocks. Right, what's broken?
Oh, no, shit, I'm on fire. I'm on fire.
Son of a bitch.
They've breached the hull. They've breached the hull. Oh, God, everything's on fire.
Everything.
We're getting away. Can't
the other guy in our team's like, everything's on fire, fix it.
Dude, you've got us.
Of course we do.
We got one gunner, and I swear to God, he's a blindfolded Minimar child. Flapping ineffectually.
Oh, amazing. Fire!
Oh,
fire!
Shit,
fire! Oh, fucking hell, I went down a ladder by accident.
Fucking boy guns, please.
I can't do that! Oh shit, yeah, I can.
Burn!
Yes,
burn!
Aha!
You shall die, blowjob.
Now burning.
That is one toasted blowjob. Oh shit.
Mmm, toasty blowjobs.
Mmm, my favorite kind. There it is.
Man the port gun.
Which side's port? Spabbles isn't here to teach me port and starboard.
Port has four letters, so does left.
They're nearly dead. Kill them.
Don't kill me. I have so much to live for.
Man the front guns and kill them.
Getting on the front guns.
Hiding from you. I'm hiding from you.
Descend,
I'm
going to
go help out
descend.
My friend taking out the Swole Mole.
The Swole Mole.
The manlet superhero.
I've heard of. I've done against the Swole Mole before.
Keep the entrance check, please.
I'm doing it. This guy nags and nags and nags.
Well, that's what you got to do to be the captain. You got to nag.
That's a good point.
Right, I'm out of range. Shit.
Where is the Swole Mole? I can't see it.
Oh, I can see.
Man the four guns!
Oh, why are you-
It's not the four guns! It's the left gun so I can set everything on fire! Yeah, buddy! Fuck yeah, buddy! Oh shit, we're very much on fire!
Get fucked!
Oh shit, get burned!
Down.
How the fuck did that go south so fast?
Mate, you got in range of my massive shotgun cannon.
You've seen that. The other engineer doesn't know what she's doing.
Oh, creeps, are you gonna take that?
What is he? Someone chatting?
Fuck you.
Someone chatting nonsense on your team?
Yeah, he just said, turns out the other engineer, she doesn't know what she's doing.
Oh.
I can barely hear him, that's the problem! This time we'll get some
results. He goes, maybe if we actually work together this time we'll get some results.
I doubt it.
What? Tell him! I can barely hear him!
We should mention, you are quiet as fuck, which is why we can't hear you.
Me or him?
Can you hear me now?
Yeah, you're a bit better now.
Alright.
Alright. All right, now.
I will do my best to be obedient this time.
I will not.
Right, would help if any of the ships were, like, here. Because you guys have got the other guns, so...
I see you, Blowjob! We're coming for you!
We're going after
the block. Ed, if you know port and starboard, what's bow and stern? Is it bow and stern? Is it bow? I don't know. Tell me. Tell me which one's right. Toasted blowjobs, the best way to start a British breakfast.
When you go amazing.
Ed, you're gonna have to like sort of transcribe what you're saying for me.
Sorry?
You're gonna have to like transcribe what the captain's saying.
I'll relay it to you whenever
Thank
he speaks.
You're too kind.
Get.
Fuck you, blowjob! Fuck you, blowjob! Fuck you!
Oh, that was a nasty hit.
I'm not
yeah!
Anything.
We destroyed him!
Okay. I'm taking this out, so that's what I'm doing.
Reloading! 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 Fix
the
hull!
Thank you.
I'm doing.
Win. Get the fucking work, please.
Get out of there.
Oh my god! Jesus, dude.
I wish I could hear what's
He's
going
just
on
being that. Like, Queen, get to fucking work.
I'm getting to work, shut up.
Queen, actually do some fucking work. He doesn't have spammers to tell him parts of the ship. No, I don't.
This is why I told you guys I wanted to be the gunner last time. Because everyone just knocks at me when I'm the engineer.
Oh, this grenade launch is fucking sick.
Right, where are the... Oh, they're in front of us. Right, I can't do anything then.
QC, if he transcribes it, he'd be writing it down. You can't hear text. He's got a point.
Oh, we blew... Something blew up.
Reloading, 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 reloading.
Shut the fuck up. I don't take orders from anyone, bitch. Here we go. See, I'm shooting. Are you happy now, Captain?
This.
See, are you happy now, Captain? I'm shooting.
Bug!
The blowjob!
I'd be more happy if you fixed the hull.
I fear no
I'd
evil.
Be more happy if you fixed the hull, he just said.
What happened to your
I
balloon?
I know.
Shit. Wait, where's the balloon? This thing? No, we're good, we're good.
I'm repairing the balloon. Yes!
I'm never being the engineer again after this, guys.
Like, why?
Because it sucks!
On the front guns!
Oh my god, it's got blown too.
There's nothing here! There he is.
Now there is.
Oh shit, they're firing flamethrowers at us.
Yes, they are.
Gonna get some fire damage.
Burn more,
oh,
bitch.
Ah! Oh.
Fire! Unload! Fuck these guys!
Shit, yeah, I'm gonna fix it. Wrong way. Fire.
Yeah! Oh, this has actually been a fucking solid round.
I'm fixing it, don't worry.
For all the shit that guy's giving,
Also, I meant on fire, not in fire.
You guys are doing really well.
I meant on fire, not in fire. The balloon is in fire!
Nice try, dude.
In fire! Oh shit, it is as well!
Stop! Oh, fucking idiot.
Well, where is the balloon?
I'm up here. No. It's the fucking gunner. Stop hitting this thing, dude. You don't know what you're doing and you're ruining it. Go away.
Get away.
When's Rick and Morty season 3 coming out? That's the question.
How do I reload on this? Oh, it's R, isn't it? Right, hang on.
There they are. Spot
where?
Them for me, please.
Where?
Blowjob spotted.
Engaging the blowjob.
Blowjob spotted.
Oh, in front of us. I'm nowhere near it then.
Oh god, I did a 360 by accident.
What? What is this guy even saying?
He didn't say anything.
Ramming speed ahead.
Ramming
oh my
speed
god.
Ahead.
Oh, okay, right.
Watch out for the MOBUS! Ah!
I'm waiting for him to come around to me.
Holy shit!
Burn it. Oh god, we're dying. We're gonna die and lose this game. Come on.
Yeah!
Yeah!
That's what I'm fucking talking about.
That was me! I fucking hit it!
Sup, Griever Gaming? How's it going? You've just joined at the perfect time to watch us, or Creeps and I, kill Johnny. Fuck you, Johnny. Right, so we'll probably do another one, this time as an actual team. How does that sound?
Yes.
Sounds good.
Sounds shit. Let's not do it. Clearly a man thought up this gameplay. I will fix this broken object by smashing it repeatedly with a wrench. How dare you, you very sexist Miss Lulu Faye. Not all men are thugs who hit things against other things. Some of us are.
I can't leave Johnny a commendation. I think he should be a very good commendation.
No, don't worry, Jim. We leave Discord just for the people who are in-game, otherwise it gets a bit muddled. Right, wait, can we back out? No.
Yeah.
Wait, quick. Okay, I'm over. So now we just need one of those two guys to drop out, and then... Quick!
Yes!
Yeah!
Yes!
Nice.
That's how we do it. Right.
So basically, all of my crew jumped ship.
Right.
Instantly.
Just like, fuck you, William.
I was fine. My gunner was a special man.
Dude, come on. He was a woman.
Sorry. Dribbling retard person.
You don't know him.
I believe they like to be called.
Yes, things. I believe is the correct term. The politically correct term.
More like phlegmatically correct.
I probably can't.
That's
Jesus.
Ooh, I apologize.
Jesus Christ.
To everyone who was offended by that.
I mean, too many people are offended by everything these days. Am I right?
You're right, lad.
You know, the easiest memes on the internet these days are people with this name will steal your chips, and it's just a list of 12 random names.
Oh, I saw one.
Laziest.
I saw one as well that was people who love the sesh, and it was a list of 16 names. I was like, what? Where's the creativity here? And I know most of the people on this list don't love this sesh, but you're right, that's effortless. There's nothing funny there. And the first thing you see are people in the comment sections of the crying with laughter emoji going, oh my god, babe, this is you, tag friend here. Fuck you.
Sometimes even with the name in the list.
Yeah, I know, yeah. According to COD, bullet holes in the chest can be fixed by breathing a good bit of pure air. Sounds about right. Don't you know, Ed, duct tape fixes everything except bullet holes and relationships.
Oh, wow.
Well, that's debatable.
Toaster. Toaster. Gee. Yeah, it depends what kind of things you're doing. Johnny, have you readied up? Now ready up.
I'll do it now. Yeah.
I love guinea pigs just joined us.
I'd love a...
A guinea pig?
Yes. They're tasty.
Om nom nom.
Yeah, I'd love a list that's like 12 blokes who would love to fucking besiege Constantinople. Louis the First.
Dude, can we please make one of those? Can we please make that? That'd be amazing.
The one with the
yeah, that's fine. It's your idea. I'll put credit. Right, cheers, we'll make man. That. That's so easy to make as well.
There we go.
Top guys most likely to breach Constantinople.
Crusader memes. Fucking let's do it.
So guys, what games are you enjoying lately? That's a good question. Hogs, what have you all been playing lately? What kind of things have been catching your eye? What games are you looking forward to? Are any of you excited for Destiny 2 that was just announced? Or Dauntless?
No,
a monster
hunter. Ship is the easiest ship to look around.
And to
relax.
Destroy.
Fair enough.
Actually, it is. It's so easy to remember your way around here. Right, Johnny, take us full speed ahead.
Full speed?
Yeah, full speed. I want to feel the wind rushing past my testes.
Okay.
Through my trousers.
I haven't been enjoying any recent games, but I've been playing the Penny Arcade series on my streams recently, which has been really fun.
You've been enjoying that then?
Yeah.
Good stuff.
Hey.
Hey. Whoa, holy shit, Johnny. Talk about fucking the engines with whatever that was.
You asked me to, dude.
Yeah, sorry. I said go full speed, I didn't realize you meant shall I bake the engines until they don't work anymore.
Oh, you're fixing this one.
Yeah, don't worry. I'm just kind of running around. Someone may have to go
right.
up to the rear.
Oh, no, we're the red ones, aren't we?
Breath of the Wild, because this is the week I'm ordering it. Dude, Breath of the Wild is fucking awesome. Such a good game. It's not a 10 out of 10, like everyone's saying it is, but it's easily an 8.5 to a 9 out of 10. Which is pretty fucking good.
10 points to the man who spots the first enemy.
Okay, I like the sound of this, Johnny.
I'm going to try and go through between these two bridges.
Johnny, don't do it. It's not worth it.
No, don't.
Johnny, don't do it.
No.
Johnny, no.
It's going to be fine. We can fit, as I've said on many occasions. Oh, like a goose.
Excellent. The Pyramidian is behind us, supporting us.
Pyramidian.
I think they're going to be dead ahead.
At higher than Everest.
What can?
There's an enemy on sight.
The bar-headed goose, during its migration, flies higher than Everest.
Really?
Upside. Oh, wait, yeah.
That is actually pretty interesting.
The Jean-Claude Juncker is approaching.
You know, there was a guy who wiped his ass with every known animal to see which was the softest.
Including insects? Because I'm calling bullshit on that. Unless you just got like a fistful of 8 or 9 at a time.
Like, wow. No, maybe you're right. Maybe fur-bearing animals. The rhino beetle has the perfect implement for scraping
right,
away.
Go for the sky beggar.
Right, okay.
Sky beggar.
Oh no, I'm gonna miss it before I can reload! Shit!
No!
We missed it, just completely sailed past it.
Okay, oh, I've run out of things already!
Try hitting it with your gun.
Breath of the Wild is a very relaxing game too. By the way, I would definitely recommend turning off the mini-map in that game once you do get it. Once you get used to playing for a bit and you've got the mechanics, turn off the mini-map
because
it makes the game way more what it's meant to be like. Like, you know, you're meant to rely on the wild.
It's all right, we got this. One.
Whoa!
No.
Oh, I've slammed it!
Yeah, let me fix the,
Reloading, 3, 2, 1, I've still not reloaded, but BAM!
We're dead anyway, it's fine.
Fire!
Oh, fix it in like...
Good stuff, creeps. Johnny, keep me aiming. 5, 4, three, two... Fuck! I was about to unload! Damn it.
Sorry.
Technically, insects aren't animals. Yes, they are. Technically, insects...
They're not
insects.
Bacteria.
They are definitely animals. They are objectively animals.
Already. Oh, we're so shit.
They are just not mammals.
Sorry, my bad. Fuck up, Olympic boy. Who the fuck are you?
Hi, where's Harry? I think he's next door. He's doing work.
Harry is...
How are you, Reese? Turn off the shrine locator. Yeah, that's fucking annoying. I think it tells you how to do that. Johnny, are you deploying or do we have to wait?
There we are. I'm deploying.
Right, let's do this, fellas.
There's a 30-second countdown.
Is there? No, that's long.
Woo! Wee! I'm checking it up.
Who is it who was interested in playing Horizon Zero Dawn? Because that is, Batman and Robin is a little bit of the same story, a little more time than I was the first, right, to know that he is not the best in person, and the only thing I have to say about it was the story it.
Oh, they're above us.
Dude, what the fuck does that mean?
Hey, did you just... Either you or someone else has just had a fucking stroke.
Dude, I'll read that again. Batman and Robin is a little bit of the same story in a little more time than I was the first to write to know that he is not the best person in, and the only thing I say about it was the story it.
Oh, he's on fire! I'll do it.
Things are
I did
always
it.
Gonna be
I
on fire.
I do it!
I did it. Burn!
Well enough, clearly.
Holy tits! They completely destroyed everything!
I'm fixing it!
Are you doing Quiplash again? Yes, we are, Toaster. Once we are done with this, we will jump back on Quiplash. Burn! Burn! Burn!
They're committing so much hurt on us.
Skybeggar is burning, Ralph.
Okay, that's good. Right.
Oh my god.
What the fuck?
Do they nerf this thing?
Johnny, I think they might have. I think we may have to go Pyramidian.
Because we're there's no chance.
That's brittle as shit. I didn't understand anything. Someone just died while writing this. Yeah, you're right.
Oh yes, come on. We're alright, we can do this. If we can spawn.
I'm already
in time
set,
to
I know the
out.
Console accessories game, and I will have £10 left, so I'll use my super chat soon. That's very kind, Mr. Sue, but don't feel pressured to do that. But that's very kind of you.
Give us all the money.
And once you've got your Switch, add me up on the It's not friend code anymore, is it?
Right.
Like Nintendo ID.
Right.
Add me up.
Yeah, guys, they're here. We can take them out quickly and help if we help
Shut
our team.
Up. I can't reach them.
You know, it's kind of weird. Twilight Princess Link is the most boring backstory of any Link ever, yet somehow he had the best design. He has one of the most interesting aesthetics. I bought the Twilight Princess HD remake for that reason.
Sorting everything.
But I don't know. I kind of like, I like everything about Wind Waker. That was a perfect game. In fact, once I move to my new place,
I am.
Once I move to my new place, I'm going to stream Wind Waker and Twilight Princess. Hopefully in full. Jean-Claude Juncker.
Yeah, burn the fucking thing.
I'm burning the fucking thing. I'm burning their guns, Johnny. Their guns are down. Their guns are all down. Reloading. Johnny, I'm reloading my flamethrower with lightning. Yeah, it's down! I'm guessing your name is either Ed or the Temps. It's the latter.
The Temps.
My name on everything is usually Ed Templar or the Temps. And you can try and add me on stuff if you want. Typically, I won't add people.
So,
at the moment, Erotoaster, I'm having everything at once.
Sorry?
He said either he had a seizure, heart attack, brain aneurysm, stroke, or everything at once.
I think it was a mixture of all of those, Erotoaster.
Huh? Where's the engines? Huh? Question, where are the engines?
We're at the back.
Sorry.
I am repairing the balloon.
Oh, I forgot. I've got Ego Raptor. I forgot.
Oh my god.
Enemy
I
sighted.
I am repairing the balloon.
Let me do that again. Hang on. I forgot how to do it. Wait. Enemy sighted ahead.
Whoa, that he didn't last long,
ahead.
Did he?
There's an enemy.
Oh, I like hearing Ego Raptor in my ears do that. That's great.
I know Commander Holly did one as well for the girls' voice.
Yeah, Ross and Aaron did the men. Who else did? Did Susie do one?
I don't think she did.
Was it just Holly?
Yeah.
Which is weird, because I think she's got a dead irritating voice.
Oh,
what's
I
she
like
sound like?
I like her.
Oh my god.
Hi, tweenheart!
She sounds like an adult on the telephone in
well, she, her voice, this is actually a fairly accurate impression. She's like, hi, tweenhearts! It's like, ugh! And her little intro, like, she's really likable and she's really nice and I like her a lot, but her intro is her singing with that really annoying voice going, Commander Holly, please! It's really annoying. I'll send you a link, Johnny, and you'll hear it in the first 2 seconds and go, yep, I can see exactly what you meant.
Oh shit, I'm continuously fucking the engines, didn't mean to do that.
Yeah, I know, I'm like,
fucking
right
the engines. I would make my nickname like yours, Ed. I would be the Winx. That's a good
what?
One.
What the fuck is the point of having the telescope?
So you can spot enemy ships, obviously.
It does jack shit! Like, let me use it right now.
Well, robots will always right have place. To take the best
Wait,
and most important
it?
Part in a game of a little more game and more than a story and the best right. game.
This guy's
What's
definitely
going on?
He's either trolling or dead. So
I think he's... Are you alright, dude?
Is that like, you know, when you have a stroke and people are like, he tried to message someone, West. But no one could read his messages. Is that what this is? Are we seeing someone having a really bad streak?
Those things where it's like, we just didn't know what he's saying. If you get a message, it's like, toast, help, Goethe.
You'd be like, you'd respond going, dude, mash the keypad with your hand if everything is going badly.
Yeah, they're not
going
to be like, what a joker.
A bunch of jokers.
Someone needs to call an ambulance.
Look at this.
Are we kicking ass again?
Yeah, dude, this is it. We take out the Claude Van Junker.
Claude Dan Van Junker!
Go.
Yeah, shoot main gun! Shoot main gun! Fire creeps, fire!
I'm firing!
Bringing us round.
Just waiting for it to recharge.
Wampus.
No, don't hit my gun, Get in range.
This is fine.
Hey, I can't even hit them.
This is fine.
Johnny keeps turning. I can't hit them.
Yes, because we've got a much bigger, more powerful gun right on front.
Oh, God. Hull armor's down.
Oh, yeah, you guys focus on repairing. We've got this guy.
No, I repaired. I got an achievement for something.
Did you?
Yeah.
Well, from your one achievement.
Oh, no.
Fire.
I got it.
And now set.
Robot game was fun to watch game, but in the game has to have the best story. Me to the story in gameplay on my phone to get a story to line where you get a story and then the.
I'm glad you have a strong international audience.
Oh my god, that was so close. No, stop!
Stop hammering. There we go.
Come on. We just gotta kill Claude. If we can kill Claude.
Yes! Two in a row! Oh, holy shit. Right. That's been a lot of fun, guys, but it's time to jump back into another round of Quiplash. So, Johnny, Creeps, thank you very much for joining me.
Always a pleasure.
Always a pleasure, guys. And I will see you for the next one.
Good timing.
Yes.
Byzies.
Well done. How's you do? You sounded quite
charming. We won!
Well played.
Right. It's time for us to do some Quiplash and then we're done.
Oh, right, how are we doing, guys? Who's still here?
Beano Cooker Raid. Ah, Beano Cookie's making us, he's raiding us again.
Oh, no.
Hi, Bee Hooper. Yeah, we've been raided by Beano Cookie again. Woo! Yeah.
This is always good fun.
I wonder if we respond going hashtag I prefer the dandy, if he'll actually get it. But he probably won't, because he's probably not old enough. Thank you for raiding us, guys. Welcome to our stream.
But the Beano's come back into prominence lately, hasn't it?
It has.
Eddie Dudley's doing writing for it, and Tom Sky, I think, does a bit.
Really?
I know Eddie does. I don't know if Tom...
I remember Eddie talking about it at MCM, but I've never actually seen it. Yeah. I've not been in a fucking news agents for ages, to be fair.
Speaking of MCM, you guys know that we're coming to MCM again this year?
I have your messages on a text file now. Do you actually, Mystery Soup? Could you please record those and send those to me? Raid, oh my god, you're pink. Hi, Insane Gamer. Thanks, Beano Cookie. Second time you've done this.
Good to have you here.
Much appreciated. Welcome, everyone. We're about to play some Quiplash. If you guys would like to join in, then stick around for a few minutes. We're only streaming for another 20 if you guys want to be here and play. By the way, worst name for a company? Hurray. Or Horry. I live for a game of Game of Thrones. And I have the game, but it has to have the story of a game to be the story of a story game. But I have a little bit more of the game and the game and the... Dude, you are just having a stroke in the stream. You've done this 4 times now. Where are you from, Rob Nuke? Rob Ook? That's a better question. Are you English? If not, where are you from? Spreckensy Dutch? I don't know. Okay, I'm back. Hi, Creeps.
Alright, guys. Quiplash, one last round. You playing this time, or is it just...
Nope. He had another stroke or aneurysm. Or a strenurism. Sargreaver.
Alright, guys. One last round of Quiplash. 7 slots remaining. Who's gonna get them? What's up, dudes? Roguebook is English, okay. Good to know.
Then you definitely don't have an excuse. I do have, and it's growing.
Yeah. Very good.
I still believe it's Google Translate talking over his text.
Wouldn't surprise me.
I'll pass, because I need to go in like 10 minutes. It's fine.
One last one open, guys. Who's going to have it?
Any of the raiders gonna come play?
Yeah, raiders, they came and still here. Come play Quiplash.
Miss Lily Faye, she's joined in.
Here she is, alright, good stuff. From Australia. I can't do the accent, I never could.
Of which?
Australian.
Australian.
Good eye.
It's all racism.
But I moved to Clapham recently. So many Australian women around, I don't know why.
Because they all work behind bars. Gotta have them working somewhere. I'm Batman is a little more of a... Stop doing this, mate.
I'm Batman.
I'm gonna start deleting the messages now because I realize he's not a retard, he's a troll.
Okay. Time for round one. Trolls.
Remove.
Oh, been removed.
Oh, leaving so early, Queen Creeps? I'm playing as the Phil. You score based
on the percentage of players who like your Alright, Quiplash. Trying for a win this time, my answers last time were weak sauce. Can't be having that.
Let's do this. Are you in here, Beano? Are you one of the players? Yeah, I'm going to an early release of a new book. What's the new book? Anything we'd know?
Ah, shit. Press the wrong button. That is not going to look good. I had a good one that as well.
Damn, well, shit. I wanted to join and the stream froze, so I couldn't see the code. Don't worry. Ah, Beano, you managed to get in. Nice. Now we're going to be judging your answers incredibly harshly, Beano, so these better be fucking funny. Ooh, let's hope you enjoy your evening. Yes. It's called Dragon's Green, kind of like a Harry Potter-style book. It's written by one of my English professors at uni. Oh, that's cool.
Professor Vasquez, perhaps?
Fucking Vasquez.
I pressed the enter button too soon and it logged on my answer before I'd finished writing it. I'm quite upset about that because it was quite a good answer as well, but
maybe Robook 12 is a retard and a troll. I'm claiming back the word retard, by the way. We need to take it back from obscurity and offensiveness. We don't.
Oh boy, Ed! I mean, I don't think you use that word.
Oh, gee, Rick! I don't think they appreciate being called, you know, retarded. It's a figure of speech, Morty. Actually, mentally retarded is the term.
I'm not disparaging the differently abled. I'm just pointing out the fact that if I'd used this, it would have made me retarded. Well, I don't know. I think it's become just a...
I think it's kind of derived to become a lot more offensive than it is now, Rick.
Well, that's retarded.
You're retarded, Morty. Scarlett Thomas is her name. Sounds like a pseudonym. She wrote the book we used on our creative writing course.
All right.
Seems a bit self-indulgent. Welcome to my study. You shall learn about the book that I wrote, because I understand. Actually, that's first-hand accounting of how to write a book. I suppose that is the best way of being taught creative writing.
Well, it depends how popular it was.
That's a good point. What you really want is J.K. Rowling. Actually, you don't want J.K. Rowling if you want to learn how to write a book properly. She writes amazing stories, but God, fuck me, has no idea how syntax works.
Yeah.
Honestly, read any given paragraph in a Harry Potter book, and I guarantee you'll find some grammar wrong with it. Again, come back when you've written as many, you know, bestseller books as she had, sort of thing, but credit where credit's due and criticism where criticism is due.
I don't think that's about, like, just because something's popular doesn't make it good. And I say, yeah, fair play to her for being.
But no, but the storyline is very enjoyable.
Of course it is, but that doesn't excuse the lack of grammar.
No, it doesn't.
Especially the fact the kids are going to read it. You think it would have proofread it a bit. But.
The kids reading it is always something where I've been like, right, it's accessible for people who are younger and people who are older, so it's very middle ground. But the people who always said, like, I'm rereading Harry Potter for the fourth time, was the children's book not enough? Dude.
Ooh, $5.
Thank you, dude. I enjoy watching your stream, guys. Hashtag cookie hype. Thanks, dude. Cookie. Appreciate the Australian dollar.
By the way, my thing for this was dropping the penny by Confidering, because it's
dropping.
Yeah.
In the first book, J.K. Rowling listed magic wand twice. What do you mean? I'm sure there's more than one sentence including the word magic wand. Haha, I agree. I read the first two books recently, and I kind of cringe. The later books are better. No, the later books are actually some of the worst. They have some. I don't know if she just got lazy by that point, but that has some of the worst syntax. Again, I enjoyed the book, so I'm not being a total asshole about the Harry Potter franchise, but they are badly written in terms of their syntax, and just calling it out.
And the structure as well.
Yeah, I mean, I think I said this exact quote, but that she is dreadful at superfluous dialogue with no exposition being weaved in, and just does on-the-nose lines like, Cornelius Fudge, he's the new Minister of Magic, don't you know? And that's just so CBeebies.
Yeah.
Next one. Thank you, Beano. We appreciate it.
Into a
we do.
vote on your devices.
I'm sorry your thing didn't come up. I've not managed to get them to work. But you're up here, so I suppose that's all that matters.
Yeah.
I remember that. There's a list of there's a list the students need in their school stuff, and early publication rolling lists magic wand twice. Okay. In a shopping list, it started with magic wand, then magic wand was written again in the middle of the shopping list.
Right, really. Next up.
What's your favorite Harry Potter book, Ed? And you, Harry? In terms of book,
it's voting time.
Probably Order of the Phoenix I really liked. I don't know why. And Half-Blood Prince I really liked. It was one of the last three.
I only read the first four, of which I'd say the Goblet of Fire was the best one.
Definitely out of those four. Definitely.
But I gave up. I just didn't enjoy them.
But that you gave up at the point where it started becoming less children-y.
I still think it was a children's series at heart.
I mean, it is. But like, it's family oriented. You can get the adults in and it's still very likeable and enjoyable. I didn't realise how much I loved Harry Potter until I went to the Harry Potter studios and basically became a child again.
Plus, like, you know, when it comes to plot holes, like in the third book with the time turner, like, you could have easily explained that and said after they used it that one time, they all got destroyed for some reason. But no, they still exist. And yet they don't go and save anyone's life or anything like that.
But they all got destroyed for some reason would give you that would piss you off, wouldn't it?
I prefer that than they still exist and they didn't use them because it's all against the rules.
It's a deus ex machina.
What, a gift from God?
No, that's not what Deus Ex Machina means. Yeah, no, it means King of the Machines in literal terms. But Deus Ex Machina is just a plot device that's not established, that therefore comes in. Actually, which technically would make it not a Deus Ex Machina, because it's technically established at the beginning of the film.
That's round one.
Actually, no, it isn't. It's kind of subtly woven in.
Two is straight ahead, and that means all points that, are doubled.
Could be defined as that, I guess, he says, looking at the Google.
Well, it's a different thing. It's remains depending on the where it originated from.
In literary terms, it means a plot device that's not established that comes in and saves some or rescues a protagonist. Like the eagles in at the end of Lord of the Rings are a classic cliche that's used to define Deus Ex Machina because they aren't established as being on their way prior to that moment.
Oh, I guess that's where the phrasing all the gift from God comes, because it's not literal, it's more sort of hypothetical.
Deus Ex Machina means God of the Machines, it doesn't mean gift from God.
No, but let's leave this.
Shit, sorry, I fell a freaking sleep. Play one more round after. I don't think we can. So guys, since the stream is almost over, let me officially say that I'm back and happy to watch your streams again. I miss it a lot, and it made me feel like I was no longer a part here. Silly, I know. Well, it's nice to have you back. It's lovely to have you back, and I'm glad that you're out of the clinic. That's odd, my last message didn't appear. It's God in the machine. Or God of the machine, yeah. But now you're back. Yes, so this is great. Hi guys, what game are you playing? Hi Jakester123, we're playing Quiplash. This is a game that we're playing with you guys. Unfortunately, you can't join because it's too late, but if you come and join any of our other streams, you'll be able to.
That's tight. Just getting on time.
How Garfield, the cartoon cat, will eventually die.
That's a dark question.
Okay, everyone, vote for your favorite.
Dude! Yeah,
technically, Garfield actually is already dead. There was a very dark comic that was once written. I can't remember what it was, but there was sort of a weak comic Jim Davis did where it explores Garfield's psyche and reveals he's like a lone cat dying in a room in an empty house on his own. Really dark. Do check that out. It makes for good reading, and it explores sort of themes about loneliness and being himself and all that kind of stuff. Well worth a read.
And then there's the anime Mirai Nikki, where God is literally called Deus Ex Machina. I see. Ah.
I like the National Treasure movies.
They're very enjoyable.
They're fun. They're like, they're not trying to be anything other than what they are, which is just fun.
Yeah. I like the, something I've seen loads recently is Knowing. But have you guys seen Knowing? It's a terrible, terrible Nicolas Cage film. But it keeps coming on telly. And for some reason, me and my dad really like it, because it's dreadful, but it's quite watchable, and you don't have to think about it too much. And the game Deus Ex. But that doesn't contain the word Machina, which makes a totally different thing. Okay, I must be off. See you, creeps. Thank you for coming.
Bye, creeps.
What's the advice your boxing coach could give you? He hits you because he likes you. Just eat what okay, I will the 500 ice creams. What the fuck was Reese's answer?
Quiplash, bitches!
Just eat what okay, I will the 500 ice creams. Did you even try?
Just eat what? Okay. 500 ice creams. Was that what it was supposed to be?
But either way, what the fuck does that mean? I'm coming back in a few seconds. Okay. Is this The Knowing with Nicole Kidman in it? The thriller? No, that's The Others, isn't it? Or is... Oh, no. No, it's called Knowing, not The Knowing.
Yeah, just Knowing.
Think about sex and Emma Watson.
Sex with Emma Watson?
I like the specificities of that. I think about sex and Emma Watson.
Has anyone seen the new Beauty and the Beast film? How bad is it? Someone tell me. Like,
if one of you didn't put McLove in. Come on! Guys! It was right there! It was set up for you! Fuck!
I never found that film that funny, you know?
It's alright, but it's not as... Everyone bums it. Look, again, fan bases and internet people. You make something way funnier than it is. Like, Zach Galifianakis' character in The Hangover isn't remotely funny. But the internet loved him, and so he became memes. And then there'd be pictures of just him doing this, with an unrelated caption. Will Ferrell as well, he's become one of those.
Actually, I thought his performance in The Hangover was fantastic, he was very funny.
But I hated his character, I hated what he was. Yeah. But it's just stupid equals funny, and it's like, it's funny for a bit, but it's not funny for a 2-hour film. The hardest part about living in a submarine. No Beatles. But they all live there. So there's four Beatles.
Not anymore, that's not.
Have to check that one out. I have just been waiting forever for the third... There's a third National Treasure movie?
Yeah, they're still making it, but they gotta wait till, They say the reason they're taking so long is to do so much research so it makes more sense, but I don't know if I believe that.
I don't believe that for a second. And then he became the Joker in the Lego Batman movie. Next he did a good job voicing the character. Six, still never seen seven, any of the Lego movies, but I've heard they're great.
The first one was fantastic. I didn't see the Batman one, but the first one was very good.
I've seen Knowing. Oh yeah, Knowing was interesting until the end. You're right. It's actually an okay watchable film. And then they just went, fuck, we need to end this. And then it really, really, really just starts going, what if it's aliens and it's all a metaphor for creation? What? No. Everything else up until that point was at least tangible and interesting.
Yeah.
I bought the Nintendo Switch with Zelda. Should I buy Mario Kart 8 or wait to Splatoon? Buy them both. They come out like 3 months apart from each other. You don't have to buy one and not the other. Buy both. They are different games and I guarantee you'll play both to death. I played the, Splatoon 2 test fire over the weekend, which was fucking awesome. It's such a fun game. So excited for the full release. Yellow Submarine got the worst translation in French ever.
What does it get translated as?
Nous allons habitons en une submarine jaune. Something like that. That really just doesn't have as much rhythm to it, does it?
Nah. Beano's still here. Thanks for by, Beano. We appreciate it. We've reached the end of round. All right, scores on the doors at half time. What are we looking at? And just like that, from last into fourth place.
Green submarine, not yellow submarine. Nous sommes tous dans un sous-marin vert.
No. Tripled, and everyone told you.
There's green. Single prompt this time. Your last prompt is... I don't understand. I was at least hoping for an anti-semi-horror thriller ending, like some weird supernatural thing, but yeah, fucking aliens. I don't mind the it's a giant metaphor for creation thing, but they just delivered it so fucking ham-fistedly and terribly. Everything else up until that point made sense, but when you suddenly go, by the way, the clues we've been following throughout the entire film lead to the end of the world, how do you end the film? Apart from just ending the world. So I suppose they realised, shit, we need to staple something onto the end of this because it doesn't have a satisfying end. And it still doesn't.
I mean, name one film that got made better by the presence of aliens. Like
aliens?
No, you know, like as a plot device.
Signs? Bear in mind how different these films would be without aliens.
No, you know what I mean, like, same example, Indiana Jones.
But those were shit films. Okay, I need to go. I'm just going to write my answer. See ya. Bye-bye, Toaster. Thank you for coming. We'll see you on Thursday.
All of this together.
I don't know why they had to change the color. They actually changed the color? That's why it's green submarine?
Well, presumably because there were too many syllables otherwise.
Well, Vare and Joan have the same number of syllables.
That's stretched, yeah.
Submarine. Okay.
Eh.
That's such a... I'm trying to think through the process of why it was localized so badly for the French. It's like all, with almost every series I've watched, when they're out of ideas, let's have some evil werewolf slash zombie slash vampire slash Nazis or any other evil mutant stuff. Sounds like you're watching pretty crap series by the sounds of it, if they all seem to descend into let's put in a werewolf, vampire, zombie, or Nazi. Damn, but it cuts me off every third round while I'm typing.
Oh no.
In the song they changed the colour, the submarine is not yellow anymore, it's green. It's a jealous submarine.
Bye, our toaster.
See you, mate.
Potato. Yes, I heard about this. They changed to Barbob Rainbow Sheep, didn't they?
I don't believe this. I'm actually going to Google to check that this isn't nonsense, because I've never actually seen this. Barbob Rainbow Sheep myth. Is this true, or is it real? The myth, the truth. A couple of nurseries in Oxfordshire decided to make the song longer and more stimulating for children by replacing black with a range of other adjectives. This is one of the biggest PC gone mad urban myths that spread across the country and the world. The book entitled Bar Bar Rainbow Sheep, The Charge of the PC Brigade, was even published based on this incident.
Wow.
Of course, this ban has actually happened. It would have been a very pointless and hysterical matter indeed, but it didn't happen at all. So no, it doesn't exist. It is still Bar Bar Black Sheep, because there is nothing racial about pointing out colours of things. Do you like Bat Cow? I don't know what that is.
It's like the point of the nursery rhyme is just like, they go to the sheep gives them wool. It's like, it doesn't matter if they're black or white.
Yeah.
Does it? Like,
it's not a racial thing either. You could try and tie it to fucking slavery if you really wanted to, but it's not. Oh shit, we're done with the game. Well done, everyone. I don't know who won.
I mean, in fairness, there aren't many black sheep out there. Unless they mean black sheep is in the black sheep of the family.
But Harry, should we be addressing the problem of equal opportunities for black sheep at early stages of life?
Well, I mean, they want to get shorn just like the rest of us, and that's their own predicament. Yeah, I
feel like we may be profiling. But, yeah, the crown is mine. Damn it, Beano, you raid our thing and then you win our games, but congratulations and thank you for sending some people over here. We'll be sure to do the same to you at some point.
Aren't all sheep black, surely? Because the heads are black and the body is black and it's just the body is white wool.
No, not all sheep's faces are black.
They're a jar, aren't they?
No, you get white face sheep.
But I'd say they're in the minority. It's mostly black face sheep.
Goodness, an opposite of society. An intrigue. I don't know, I suppose you're right, but...
And then, like, when they shear the wool off, I mean, you don't see many. There's no use for
black. Also, it's
wool.
A fleshy colour underneath.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's like a pink colour, not a black orb.
Yeah. So, if anything, the black sheep is held in high regard for being unique. There you go.
There you go. No more rainbow sheeps. Anyway,
actually,
on that bombshell.
Last
no?
Last year's a music festival held in.
I know what latitude is, but I've never been.
And they have sheep grazing the land all year round.
Right.
And instead of moving them off, they just dye their wool rainbow colours. And let them continue to graze.
Really?
It's great.
That's actually pretty good.
Yeah.
Anyway, guys, on that sheep-based bombshell, you missed everything, I'm afraid, Fizzy Panda, but enjoy the video that is up today, which is House Party.
Yes.
Which was weird as shit. So go check that out on the channel. It is available now. It's good fun, involves lots of boobs and stuff, if any of you guys are really interested in that. But we will see you guys for videos tomorrow and another live stream on Thursday.
Yes, see you then, guys. Sort of been a bit quiet today. We're quite tired, but hopefully you'll be a bit more energetic then.
Indeed. Take care, guys.
Bye.
Bye.